Chapter 6, Coffee and Tea Making Essentials. In order to make coffee, you need a coffee maker and coffee. But did you know there are many gadgets and accessories that can make your life easier while helping you brew the perfect cup? In this chapter, we're going to take a look at coffee making essentials and learn what they are, how they're used, and why you need them. Coffee filter. If you've ever brewed a cup of coffee in an automatic or drip coffee maker, then you are probably familiar with coffee filters. A coffee filter is important because it brings out the best flavor in your coffee by catching grinds and some of the bitter taste while allowing the flavor and color of the beans to flow through. The most common coffee filter is the paper filter. Paper coffee filters are available in a variety of sizes and shapes, with the most common being a cone or round shape. White coffee filters are made from paper pulp, which has been bleached. Some coffee drinkers feel that bleached filters have a negative effect on coffee flavor and recommend using unbleached brown coffee filters instead. Paper coffee filters are available in different grades, allowing you to easily and quickly change the taste of your coffee by using a different grade of filter. Paper coffee filters are disposable and generally inexpensive. They can be found in most grocery stores, convenience stores, and drug stores. An option to paper coffee filters is to use a permanent one. Permanent coffee filters are wire mesh made from stainless steel. These reusable filters are formed into either a basket shape or a cone shape to fit the various types of coffee makers. Many coffee makers are now being sold with permanent coffee filters. These types of filters are easy to clean, and you can simply wash them out in your sink or pop them into your dishwasher. Permanent coffee filters don't seem to filter out the bitterness as well as paper filters, and can be somewhat messy to clean. However, they can save you a little bit of money, and they are environmentally friendly. Gold coffee filters are a favorite choice amongst coffee connoisseurs. A gold-toned coffee filter is constructed from stainless steel that's been enhanced with gold plating. A Swiss gold coffee filter is made from real 23-karat gold, which gives it even more longevity. Both types of gold filters eliminate the need for a paper filter. Those who use a gold coffee filter claim there is a definite difference in the flavor of their brews. They say it makes the coffee more lively, vibrant, and complex. One major advantage of a gold coffee filter is longevity. Another advantage is that in the long run, you'll probably save money. Gold coffee filters range in price from $8 to $25 and can last for years. Another advantage of a gold coffee filter is flavor enhancement. A gold coffee filter allows more oils to remain in the brewed coffee, giving it a richer and more intense flavor. Paper filters are designed to absorb a significant amount of the oil surrounding the ground and roasted coffee beans. In doing so, much of the coffee's complex flavors that are contained in the oil are absorbed in the filter. The only downside to using a gold coffee filter is that occasionally smaller grinds escape through the filter and end up in the finished product. Gold coffee filters are relatively easy to maintain. The only work required is to empty the used grounds and rinse it thoroughly. Last but not least, a relatively new product on the market is the hemp coffee filter. Using high-quality hemp fabric, filters are constructed as a cone or basket filter and inserted into the coffee maker just like any other filter. Hemp coffee filters are one of the most environmentally friendly choices you can make. You simply need to rinse them out after each use and allow to air dry. Hemp coffee filters can also be washed in a washing machine. Hemp tea bags are also available. These are great for brewing whole leaf tea and are suitable for a quick cup of tea or a full pot. Another use for hemp tea bags is to fill them with dried herbs such as lavender or cinnamon and toss them in the bath water for a relaxing herbal bath. Hemp coffee filters and tea bags can oftentimes be found in health food stores or grocery chains such as Wild Oats or Trader Joe's. If you can't find any in your area, type in hemp coffee filters at your favorite search engine and you're certain to find exactly what you're looking for. Coffee grinder. While there is nothing wrong with purchasing pre-ground coffee, there's nothing better than the taste of brew made from freshly ground coffee beans. A coffee grinder will grind roasted coffee beans into little grounds that are fine, medium, or coarse. Fine to medium grounds are best for traditional coffee makers. Those who love espresso will want to grind the beans into fine grounds, similar to sugar or salt. Coarse coffee grounds are also good for use in percolators and vacuum brewers. There are two main types of coffee grinders. The first type is a blade grinder, which uses rotating metal blades that chop up the coffee beans. The blade grinder is the cheapest and easiest type of coffee grinder to use. Equipped with a motor and a blade, just throw in the beans, place the cover on the grinder, and push the start button. The grinding blade rotates and breaks the coffee beans into small pieces. This type of coffee grinder allows the user to control the grind of the beans. For coarse grounds, little grinding is required. For fine espresso grounds, simply leave the grinder on for a few more seconds. Regardless of the duration of the grind, the grounds will contain sizes ranging from powder to chunks. The difference? Just the quantity of these sizes. The second type of coffee grinder uses a grinder wheel, and it's called a burr coffee grinder. In order to control the level of grounds, you move the burr on the coffee grinder. There are two types of burr grinders, flat blade and conical. The conical burr grinder has two cone-shaped burrs facing one another at a distance to determine the grind size. Coffee beans are fed between the burrs and then crushed when one of the burrs rotates while the other stays stationary. The flat blade grinder comes with two flat and parallel blade burrs that shear the coffee beans. This process leaves a more uniform and larger surface area for extraction. Coffee grinders work in two different ways. First, there is the manual coffee grinder that has a crank attached to the side. It's easy to use, but it does require some manual labor. These types of coffee grinders are generally more time-consuming to clean. Most people opt for the electric coffee grinder, which requires little effort to use or maintain. And there are many styles and colors to suit your decor and budget. Coffee grinders range in price from $20 on up to several hundred. There are definite advantages to grinding your own coffee. First, you can select the grind that suits your taste. Second, whole coffee beans hold their flavor longer than pre-ground coffee. When you grind your own beans, you can indulge in a fresher and tastier cup of brew. Third, it's good for your senses. The smell of freshly ground beans is a great way to start your day. Ceramic coffee canisters. Proper coffee storage can make a considerable difference in how your coffee tastes. Regardless of whether you prefer whole beans or ground, coffee should always be stored in an airtight ceramic canister that blocks light. It should also have a rubber seal around the lid so air can't get inside. Avoid using plastic or metal containers for coffee storage. These materials can alter the taste of your coffee. It's okay to use glass containers. If you use clear glass, keep the light away by storing them in a cabinet or pantry. Ground coffee will only retain its freshness for a few days after it's been exposed to air. The truth is, trying to keep ground coffee fresh is next to impossible. If you feel you must use pre-ground coffee, then purchase small amounts and replenish every few days. Freezing coffee is a bad idea. It won't help preserve the coffee and can actually harm the coffee. Water molecules attach to the coffee and the packaging. When water comes into contact with the surface of a coffee bean, ice forms around it. When the ice melts, it's absorbed into the coffee, deteriorating the taste and quality. You don't want to store your coffee in the fridge either. It's the same concept as you just listened to, except in the refrigerator, coffee is subjected to the constant cold mist inside. In terms of coffee storage, water is coffee's worst enemy. Coffee scoop. In order to measure out your coffee, it's best to use a coffee scoop. Coffee scoops are constructed from wood, plastic, copper, or stainless steel. They're available in measurements of 1 or 2 tablespoons. Some are rounded, others have a cone shape. Espresso scoops are oftentimes found with a scoop at each end. One scoop measures 1 tablespoon, while the other scoop measures 2 tablespoons for a double shot. In order to make the perfect cup of coffee, it's important to use the proper water-to-coffee measurement. To make drip coffee, the measurement is 3 ounces of coffee to 8 ounces of water. You can find a vast array of coffee scoops in retail stores, grocery chains, and specialty shops. Some of the best and most unique coffee scoops can be found in coffee shops or via the internet. Coffee mugs and cups. In order to drink your coffee, you need to have some type of container from which to drink it. Coffee mugs and cups are available in just about any form and made from a wide range of materials. Coffee cups are generally smaller and hold about 5 ounces of coffee. Coffee mugs are larger and hold between 8 and 16 ounces of steamy brew. Travel mugs are ideal for those who want to take their coffee along with them. Travel mugs generally have a handle and a lid with an opening that can be closed with a snap top. They are usually insulated and constructed from plastic or stainless steel. Many people enjoy sipping their favorite brew from a personalized coffee mug. Personalized mugs can be found in specialty stores or ordered online from coffee retailers. There are many creative coffee cups and mugs available. There is no wrong or right coffee drinking vessel. Just choose one that you like and that works best for your needs. Coffee Service Ensemble. A coffee service ensemble is essential when serving coffee or tea to family, friends, neighbors, or business associates. A traditional coffee service consists of a serving tray, coffee or teapot, sugar bowl, cream pitcher, and serving utensils. Coffee service ensembles are generally made from sterling silver or porcelain. Coffee and tea pitchers have a handle, spout, and a lid that can be opened by pressing a lever with the thumb. Sugar bowls have either a small set of tongs for removing sugar cubes or a teaspoon for serving sugar granules. Cream pitchers have a handle and spout and oftentimes have a lid similar to the coffee pot. Coffee service ensembles are not so popular as in the past, but they can still be found in fine department stores, some retail outlets, and online auctions. Oftentimes, coffee service ensembles can be located through public auctions, estate sales, and antique stores. If you entertain on a regular basis, a coffee service ensemble is a must-have. Coffee service ensembles provide you with the opportunity to make an elegant coffee or tea presentation. Using an ensemble has a tendency to make you and your guest feel like royalty. So, if you can find a nice service at a reasonable price, consider making the investment. Tea kettle. Tea kettles are known for the infamous whistle they make when the water has reached its boiling point. Most of us are familiar with the tea kettles that sit on top of the stove. Today's tea kettles are available in a variety of style, colors, and materials. Listen to what types are available. Stainless tea kettles. Stainless tea kettles are by far the most durable. Stainless steel is thicker than the traditional copper generally used for tea kettles. Copper kettles have a tendency to tarnish, leaving a bitter aftertaste in the coffee. Stainless steel doesn't tarnish the taste of boiling water, therefore providing you with a cleaner, crisper tea flavor. Stainless tea kettles are easy to clean and require little maintenance. Copper tea kettles. Tea kettles made from copper are the most practical. Copper heats very quickly, making it the most conductive material for heating tea. Copper tea kettles require more care and maintenance than stainless kettles. A copper tea kettle should never be placed over high heat for a long period of time because this will shorten its lifespan. Copper tea kettles need to be thoroughly cleaned after each use to prevent residue buildup. Some copper tea kettles have a lacquer finish, which should be polished on a regular basis. Glass tea kettles are the easiest to clean and maintain. They also tend to be more stylish, with mostly modest and minimalist designs. The downside of glass kettle is that they aren't as durable as copper or stainless and require a more delicate cleaning and maintenance process. When using a glass tea kettle, it's recommended to place a piece of metal between the stove and the base of the kettle to avoid direct heat contact. Care must be used to ensure that glass tea kettles never boil dry, because this could cause them to explode. Cast iron tea kettles. Tea kettles made from cast iron will last a lifetime. While they generally aren't very pretty, they certainly are practical. Cast iron tea kettles are much heavier and a lot thicker than any other kettle, making them the most durable of all. Cast iron tea kettles are super easy to clean and care for, and they rarely, if ever, rust. Some of the most beautiful tea kettles are made from painted enamel cast iron. These types of kettles require special care to prevent the paint from chipping. They should never hit against hard objects, nor should they ever be allowed to boil dry. Proper care of cast iron tea kettles involves keeping the kettle dry as much as possible. Immediately after boiling, water should be removed. If rust appears, use a solution of baking soda and lemon juice to remove it. Avoid using abrasive cleaners, as they can cause scratches that can take in rust. Cast iron tea kettles have become collector's items and can oftentimes be found at antique stores, auctions, and estate sales. Modern tea kettles are available in most retail stores and specialty shops. There are many unique tea kettles available online and through online auctions. Tea infusers, also known as tea balls. These wire mesh balls are constructed from stainless steel, and they consist of two sections which latch together. Simply add the proper amount of loose leaf tea, close, and latch, then submerge in hot water. Tea infusers can be used in teapots or directly in a cup. They have a small chain attached, so you can drape it over the side of the cup or easily extract it from a teapot. Some tea infusers consist of two solid pieces that fit together. The upper portion has tiny holes, which allow the tea to be infused in the water as it steeps. This type of tea ball generally is held together through a twisting motion of the two containers. If the two containers aren't sealed properly, The top can pop off during steeping and leave quite the mess. Personally, I find the mesh infusers with the latch to be more user-friendly. Teabag squeezer. Teabag squeezers look like miniature tongs, generally constructed of stainless steel. Teabag squeezers are available in two sizes, small and large. The tongs are shaped like a tiny spatula with holes. The flat surface allows you to place the teabag between the two spatulas and squeeze the tea through the holes. Teabag squeezers are most often found in coffee tea shops and specialty stores. French press coffee maker. A French press coffee maker is a really simple yet effective way to brew coffee. Simply pour hot water into the carafe, add coarse ground coffee directly into the water, then install the lid plunger assembly. After the coffee is brewed for 3 to 4 minutes, press down the plunger and a fine mesh screen forces the grounds to the bottom of the carafe. French press coffee is smooth and silky with a light mouth feel and intoxicating aroma. Electric French press coffee makers are just as easy to use as a regular coffee pot or coffee maker, but it makes your coffee taste a lot better. You can also brew tea and soups in a French press coffee maker. Electric French press coffee makers are a great addition to any kitchen and take up less space than a regular coffee pot. They are generally quite elegant looking and range in price from $29.95 to $89.95. Last but not least, a great coffee press alternative is Travel Press Coffee Maker. This unique gadget holds 8 ounces of freshly pressed coffee and features a double-walled design that provides insulation to keep the coffee hot. Stovetop Espresso Maker. A stovetop espresso maker is a must-have, especially if you love aromatic and tasteful coffee, also known as macchinetta or mocha pot. The stovetop espresso maker is one of the most popular ways to make espresso at home. This type of espresso maker is great for brewing and frothing the old-fashioned way. Stovetop espresso makers are also great to take along when traveling or camping. The stovetop espresso maker doesn't brew actual espresso, but a strong Italian-style coffee. It works by creating pressure through heat to force water through finely ground coffee and into a serving chamber. The stovetop espresso maker consists of 3 little sections. The bottom section, that's where the water is held. Ground coffee is placed in a funnel-shaped filter in the midsection, and the upper part receives the brewed coffee. The top section screws onto the bottom part, holding the filter in between. The espresso maker is placed on the stove, and as the water boils, pressure increases in the bottom part, pushing the water through the coffee into the top reservoir. It's important to note that many of the stovetop espresso makers sold in the United States are constructed using cheap aluminum. Coffee interacts with aluminum, and it will leave a very bad flavor in your coffee. If you're going to purchase a stovetop espresso maker, invest in one which is constructed from food-grade stainless steel. Home coffee roaster. Many people are turning to home roasting their coffee. It's really quite simple and cost-effective, and it gives you much better control over the quality and roast of the coffee. Home roasting can be as easy as making popcorn, and it only takes between 6 and 16 minutes. You can roast enough in one batch for several days' enjoyment, and the results are equal to, and often fresher than, professionally roasted coffees. Coffee roasters range from stovetop poppers to roasting drums. Prices range from $39 to $699. If you decide to become involved in home roasting, it's pretty wise to do your homework on the various types of roasters and roasting methods. One thing you will need for certain is a thermometer that reads up to 550 degrees Fahrenheit. You'll also need a scale that weighs in pounds and grams. One of the best websites to locate info about home coffee roasters is Sweet Maria's. Their website provides a comprehensive look at various roasting techniques and roasting instructions and can be found at sweetmarias.com/instructions.html. Roasting coffee at home requires the use of green coffee beans. On average, green coffee beans cost between 20 to 40% less than roasted ones. If you drink a lot of coffee, you can obtain significant savings by roasting your own beans. And you receive an additional bonus of coffee aromatherapy as the roast fills your home with a delightful scent of coffee. Chapter 7. Coffee and Tea Condiments. If you like to alter the flavor of your coffee through the use of sweeteners, creamers, or flavored syrups, this chapter is for you. Never before have we had so many choices, and the possibilities for coffee creations are endless. Listen to all of the various types of coffee and tea condiments that are available. White sugar. And there are many types of granulated sugar, but the most common form available to you and me is regular, extra fine, or fine sugar. White sugar is available in individual packets, canisters, 1 to 10 pound bags, and sugar cubes. Buying in bulk is the most economical way to purchase sugar. Individual packets and sugar cubes generally cost more per pound, but provide additional convenience. Personally, I think serving sugar cubes with tea or coffee is much more elegant than dumping in a teaspoon or two. The choice is completely up to you, of course, as each form is effective in sweetening either coffee or tea. Raw sugar is a natural, unrefined sugar made from sugarcane. Juice is extracted from the sugarcane, then crystallized through evaporation. The crystals are rinsed with a small amount of water to remove the sticky resin produced by the cane. Raw sugar is also referred to as turbinado sugar. It's available in individual packets or bulk. Raw sugar is available in some major grocery chains. Bulk raw sugar can be found in most health food stores. Liquid sugar is made from pure cane sugar, and it comes in a variety of types, including white sugar, turbinado sugar, and organic sugars. Liquid sugar is sold under the name of sugar shots, and it's available only through select retailers. It's convenient and easy to use, although it's a little on the expensive side. A 12-ounce bottle retails for about $7 and provides approximately 24 servings. Honey is the perfect addition to nearly any cup of freshly brewed tea. Honey is primarily composed of fructose, glucose, and water. It also contains other sugars as well, trace enzymes, minerals, vitamins, and amino acids. Honey is manufactured by bees. Bees gather nectar from as many as 2 million flowers to make just a pound of honey. The color and flavor of honey depend on blossoms from which the nectar is obtained. There are more than 300 types of honey in the United States alone. In general, lighter colored honeys are mild in flavor, while darker honeys are usually more robust in flavor. Honey is available in glass jars, plastic squeeze bottles, and honey sticks. Many health food stores sell honey in bulk, which can result in significant savings. Honey sticks are the most convenient form, albeit the most expensive. Artificial sweeteners. Well, at present, there are 5 artificial sweeteners approved for use in the United States. They include acesulfame K, aspartame, neotame, saccharin, sucralose. All are chemically manufactured molecules, meaning there is nothing natural about them. Artificial sweeteners are available in powder or liquid form. Most are packaged in individual packages or squeeze bottles. Acesulfame K, also known as acesulfame potassium or ACE-K, is approximately 200 times sweeter than sugar. Acesulfame K is sold under the brand names of Sunet, Sweet One, and Sweet and Safe. Aspartame is approximately 200 times sweeter than sugar. Aspartame is marketed under the NutraSweet, Equal, and Sugar Twin brands. Neotame is about 40 times sweeter than aspartame. It is manufactured by the NutraSweet company, which also manufactures aspartame. It's said that 1 teaspoon of neotame is equivalent to 8,000 teaspoons of cane sugar. Saccharin was discovered more than 100 years ago, making it the oldest of artificial sweeteners. Its sweetness depends on how it is used and ranges from 200 to 7 times sweeter than sugar. Saccharin is sold under such brands as Sweet and Low, Sweet Twin, and NectaSweet. Sucralose is 600 times sweeter than sugar and sold under the brand name Splenda. Sucralose is the most heat-stable of the artificial sweeteners, and it can actually be used in a broad range of foods and beverages. Although the Food and Drug Administration claims artificial sweeteners are safe for human consumption, there is also considerable controversy as to whether they actually are. If you are using or considering using artificial sweeteners, I encourage you to do some research. Type in dangers of artificial sweeteners or visit sweetpoison.com and shirleys-wellness-cafe.com/nutraswt.htm. Stevia is a natural sweetener derived from an herb cultivated in Paraguay. Stevia can be up to 30 times sweeter than sugar. It's available in liquid or powder form, and it's sold as a food supplement in most health food stores. Stevia has not been approved as a sweetener by the FDA. Therefore, it cannot be sold as a food product. Stevia is not conducive to baking, as it doesn't provide the same bulk as white sugar, and it requires a considerably less amount. When cooking with stevia, recipes will need to be adjusted. A conversion chart for stevia versus sugar can be found at stevia.com/stevia-sugarequivalencies.asp. Agave syrup. Agave syrup, or nectar, is a natural product derived from the juice of the blue agave plant. The blue agave is a desert succulent native to Mexico. Agave syrup can sweeten any type of beverage or food. When cooking with agave syrup, use about 1/3 cup of nectar for every 1 cup of sugar. When using agave syrup to sweeten tea or coffee, use approximately 1/3 teaspoon for every teaspoon of sugar you'd normally use. There are only 3 major producers of agave nectar in the world: Nicutli, Idea, and Blue Agave Nectar. Agave syrup has many health benefits and is an excellent choice for people who are diabetic. To learn more about agave syrup, visit blueagavenectar.com. Creamers. It used to be that if you wanted to add cream to your coffee, you either used milk, half and half, or cream. Today, there are numerous varieties of creamers for both coffee and tea. You can get non-dairy creamers, non-fat creamers, dry creamers, liquid creamers, and even flavored creamers. Creamers are available in individual plastic containers, pints, quarts, canisters, and little single-serve packets. They are generally located in the coffee aisle in the grocery or drugstore, or in the dairy case next to the milk and eggs. Powdered creamers are convenient to store and have a very long shelf life. Dairy creamers require refrigeration and generally expire with a week or two after opening. One of the more popular creamers is Coffee Mate. And Coffee Mate is a non-dairy creamer manufactured by Nestle and was introduced in 1961 and has undergone many transformations since. Coffee Mate creamer is available in powder, liquid, liquid concentrate, and soy. Coffee Mate is available in a variety of flavors, including chocolate raspberry, hazelnut, and Irish cream. You can oftentimes find discount coupons and special offers at the Coffee Mate website, located at coffee-mate.com. International Delight was launched in the 1980s and was the first flavored liquid non-dairy creamer. It originally came in 3 flavors and was available only in individual portion control sizes. Today, International Delight is available in 8 tempting flavors, 4 fat-free flavors, and 2 reduced sugar flavors. International Delight is available in quart, pint, 10.5 ounce, and single-serve portion control sizes. It can be found in the dairy section at most major grocery chains. This creamer needs to be stored in the refrigerator after opening and used within 2 weeks. Half and half. That's a mix of half milk and half cream. It's a very stable cream to be used in hot drinks such as coffee and tea. When using half and half, you should use about half the amount of other creamers. For instance, if you use a teaspoon of milk or instant creamer, use half a teaspoon of half and half. When mixed with coffee or tea, half and half produces a rich, creamy texture. Flavored syrups. Flavored syrups can be added to lattes, iced tea, hot tea, coffee drinks, smoothies, and even cocktails. Flavored syrups use natural flavors from fruits, nuts, and spices. Flavored syrups are available in a wide variety of flavors. You can enjoy everything from traditional flavors such as chocolate or vanilla to exotic flavors like boysenberry and kiwi. Flavored syrups are generally sold in 16 or 32-ounce glass bottles. They should be stored at room temperature and away from direct sunlight. Flavored syrups can be found in supermarkets, coffee shops, and specialty stores. You can also buy flavored syrups online. Chapter 8. Coffee and Tea Gift Ideas. Buying gifts can oftentimes be challenging, but when it comes to purchasing items for coffee and tea lovers, there are an abundance of choices. Gift baskets. One of the most common gifts for coffee and tea lovers is a gift basket. Gift baskets come in all styles, sizes, and colors. You can create your own or purchase a pre-made gift basket from a specialty store or a coffee shop. Oftentimes, coffee and tea gift baskets can be shipped via the mail or carrier service, or they can be delivered just like a bouquet of flowers. Coffee and tea gift baskets are generally filled with a selection of coffees and or teas, condiments, a coffee cup or mug, and sweet treats such as biscotti or tea biscuits. Coffee and tea gift baskets can be given for a variety of occasions. They're perfect for housewarming and wedding gifts. They are also great to give to friends and neighbors, teachers, and college students. Many people enjoy receiving an organic coffee and tea gift basket. This type of gift basket includes organic coffees and teas, raw sugar, stevia, or agave syrup, a hemp coffee filter or tea bag, and coffee mugs made from recycled materials. Another idea is to fill up a coffee mug with individual packets of flavored coffee, tea, or cocoa mixes. Add a chocolate-covered spoon, a handful of chocolate mints, and wrap in decorative paper. Finish it off with a bow, and you have an instant and inexpensive gift. Coffee gift baskets can be simple to elegant. As you already know, there are many coffee gadgets and accessories that can easily be incorporated into a gift basket design. Let your imagination run wild, and you're certain to come up with the perfect gift basket design. Personalized coffee cups and mugs. An affordable yet practical gift is the personalized coffee cup or mug. These are ideal gifts for corporations, as they can be used to brand a product or company. They also are perfect for individuals to give as gifts to family, friends, and loved ones. Personalized coffee mugs are available in a wide range of sizes, shapes, and colors. They can be personalized with a company logo, individual name, and even a favorite photo. You can purchase personalized mugs in the shape of a beer stein, a barrel, soup mug, or espresso shot. You can even get a personalized ashtray for those who like to have coffee and a cigarette. Stainless steel travel mugs can be personalized and make a perfect gift for those on the go. Glassware can be personalized either through a screen print process or an etching process and makes an excellent choice for tea lovers. Coffee cake. Nearly everyone who enjoys coffee appreciates a great coffee cake. Generally, coffee cakes are a dense cake, which include nuts, brown sugar, and cinnamon. They're available in a range of flavors such as banana, pumpkin, blueberry, or apple. Coffee cakes are easy to make at home, or they can be purchased at a bakery or even the grocery store. Many online gourmet food companies offer a wide range of delectable and tasty coffee cakes. You'll find a coffee cake recipe in the next chapter. It's so good you'll want to make two, one for yourself and one to give as a gift. Flavored creamers and flavored sugars. Homemade flavored creamers and sugars are a fun gift to give and really easy to make. Once the flavors have been added to non-dairy creamers or sugar, they can be transferred to glass jars or decorative containers. The container can be personalized if you desire. Add a fancy serving spoon or coffee scoop, and you have a unique and inexpensive gift. Recipes for flavored creamers and sugars are available in the next chapter. Once you've made your own, chances are good that you'll be hooked. Coffee table book. A coffee table book is a hardcover book, and it's displayed on a coffee table in an area where guests sit and are entertained. Coffee table books are generally oversized and heavily constructed. They are usually filled with photographs and illustrations, accompanied by captions. Coffee table books are intended to be browsed, as opposed to being read like a textbook or literary work. The coffee table book was conceptualized by David R. Brower while he was serving as executive director of the Sierra Club. The first coffee table book, This is the American Earth, was published in 1960 and included photographs by Ansel Adams and other well-known photographers. Coffee table books can be found in most bookstores and some retail outlets. Coffee art. Coffee art is a collection of artworks that depict anything to do with coffee. Coffee art could be as simple as a print of a coffee cup or as exquisite as a painted mural of a coffee plantation. Andrew Sauer and Angel Sarkella Sauer are artists who use coffee to create beautiful coffee art. Using coffee as watercolor paint, they create portraits, coffee themes, and even wildlife using their specialized technique. The artwork is very affordable and makes for a very interesting and unique gift. To learn more about coffee watercolor art, visit their website at justcoffeeart.com. As you know, art can mean a lot of different things to different people. For example, you might want to watch this 3-minute video of a person creating art with a cup of coffee at the following link. metacafe.com/watch/88475/coffee_art. Body art is another form of expression. The Australian Museum of Art considers this coffee cup tattoo to be, well, to be a form of coffee art. Here's the link. austmus.gov.au/body-art/tattooing/tattoo03.htm. As you can see, there are many forms of coffee art. You can find coffee art just about everywhere, from art galleries to art museums and retail stores to online galleries. Coffee art is a unique way to express your passion for coffee. Coffee tables. Coffee tables can be an expression of art as well as a functional piece of furniture. Coffee tables are designed to be lower to the ground than other tables, and they are intended to be placed in front of a sofa or love seat. Coffee tables are usually found in the living room, family room, den, or sitting room. There are many styles of coffee tables, including round coffee tables, square coffee tables, rectangular coffee tables, and even odd-shaped coffee tables. Some modern coffee tables are made from plastic or PVC. Others are made from exotic woods, such as teak. Glass coffee tables should be avoided in households that have young children, because they can be a hazard. Coffee tables with sharp edges also should be avoided in homes with young children. While glass coffee tables can be exquisite to look at, they can be a real pain to care for. Not only does the glass attract a lot of dust, it also collects fingerprints and smudges. Coffee tables make a great choice for college students and as a housewarming gift. Some of the best coffee tables can be found at yard sales, public auctions, antique shops, and even estate sales. Modern and traditional coffee tables are sold at retail outlets, fine department stores, home interior stores, and furniture stores. Oftentimes, you can find great deals on coffee tables just by shopping online or through online auctions. Coffee tables start at about $50 and can be as much as several thousand dollars. Chapter 9. Coffee Recipes. There are a lot of things you can do with coffee besides drink it. For instance, you can glue coffee beans to the side of a candle or the outside of a picture frame. Coffee grounds can be added to houseplants or garden plants to help enrich the soil. Brewed coffee can be mixed with henna to create temporary tattoos. And coffee grounds can be used as a facial scrub to help exfoliate dead skin cells. In this chapter, you'll hear about recipes for coffee drinks, flavored sugar, flavored creamer, and my favorite coffee treats, biscotti and, blueberry coffee cake. If you'd like to learn about some wacky uses for coffee, visit wackyuses.com/maxwell.html. If you'd like to learn about some wacky uses for coffee filters, visit the following link, wackyuses.com/MrCoffee.html. Okay, got a pen? Got a piece of paper? Just want to hear about them? Whatever, here they come. Coffee recipes. Flavored sugar recipe. Makes 1 cup. Preparation time, only 10 minutes. Here are the ingredients. 1 cup of finely granulated cane sugar. 1 whole vanilla bean broken into small pieces. 1 whole star anise. 1 cinnamon stick. 1 whole clove. 1/8 teaspoon ground fennel, 1/8 teaspoon ground cardamom, 1 teaspoon dried orange zest, 1 teaspoon dried lemon zest. Okay, here are the directions. Number 1, pour the granulated sugar into an airtight glass or ceramic jar with a rubber seal. Mason jars are a good choice. Number 2, place vanilla bean, star anise, and cinnamon stick into the sugar. Number 3, add the ground spices and citrus zest. 4, close tightly and store in a dark cabinet for about a week or more to give the sugar time to absorb the flavors. Use to flavor coffee, tea, baked goods, or toasted bread. rim cocktail, or a martini glass with this sweet concoction, flavored sugar makes a great gift, and it can be stored for up to a year if kept in an airtight container. Vanilla-flavored creamer recipe makes about 2 cups. Preparation time, 5 minutes. Ingredients: a cup of non-dairy coffee creamer, 1 cup of powdered sugar, 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla extract. Directions: using a jar with a screw-top lid, combine all ingredients and shake well to blend. Add 1 to 2 teaspoons to your favorite coffee or tea. Chocolate mint-flavored coffee creamer makes 2 cups. Preparation time, 5 minutes. Ingredients: 3/4 cup non-dairy coffee creamer, 3/4 cup powdered sugar, 1/2 cup Dutch processed cocoa, 1/2 teaspoon peppermint extract. Directions: using a jar with a screw top lid, combine all of the ingredients and shake well to blend. Add 1 to 2 teaspoons to your favorite coffee or tea. Irish coffee recipe serves 1. Prep time, 5 minutes. Ingredients: 1 to 1/2 ounces of Irish whiskey, 1 teaspoon brown sugar, 6 ounces hot coffee, heavy cream as desired. Directions: combine whiskey, sugar, and coffee in a mug and stir to dissolve. Float cold cream gently on top. Do not mix. Flavored coffee drink recipe, mocha coffee, serves 1. Prep time, 2 minutes, plus brew time. Ingredients: 1 cup hot brewed coffee, 1 tablespoon unsweetened cocoa powder, 1 tablespoon granulated cane sugar, 2 tablespoons milk, or 1 tablespoon half and half, 1 tablespoon whipped cream if desired. Directions: pour hot coffee into a mug, add cocoa powder, sugar, and milk, stir until well mixed, add whipped cream if desired. You could also add chocolate shavings, cocoa powder, or crushed peppermint candy to the top of this drink. Chocolate chip biscotti makes 2 dozen. Prep time, 30 minutes. Bake time, 45 minutes. Ingredients: 1 to 1/4 cup whole wheat flour, 1/2 cup semi-sweet chocolate, mini morsels, 1/3 cup granulated sugar or turbinado, raw sugar, 3/4 teaspoon of baking powder, 1 tablespoon of water, 1 teaspoon vanilla extract, 1 egg, 1 egg white, vegetable cooking spray. Directions: combine flour, chocolate chip, sugar, and baking powder in a large bowl. In a separate small bowl or cup, combine water, vanilla, egg, and egg white. Add to flour mixture, stirring until well blended. Dough will be dry. Turn the dough onto a lightly floured surface and knead 7 or 8 times. Shape dough into a 16-inch long roll. Lightly spray a baking sheet with cooking spray. Place the roll on sheet and flatten to a 1-inch thickness. Bake at 350 degrees Fahrenheit for 25 minutes. Remove roll from baking sheet and place on a wire cooling rack. Let cool for 10 minutes. Cut roll diagonally into 24 half-inch slices and place, cut sides down, on baking sheet. Reduce oven temperature to 325 degrees Fahrenheit and bake 10 minutes. Turn biscotti over and bake an additional 10 minutes. Cookies will be slightly soft in the center, but they'll harden as they cool. Remove from baking sheet. Let cool completely on wire cooling rack. Biscotti can be stored in an airtight container for up to 2 weeks. Dip in hot coffee or tea to soften biscotti cookie. Blueberry buttermilk coffee cake recipe serves 12 people. Prep time, 20 minutes. Bake time, 50 minutes. Ingredients: 1 cup whole wheat flour, 1 cup unbleached white flour, 2 teaspoons baking powder, 2 teaspoons baking soda, 1/4 teaspoon salt, 2 cups fresh or frozen blueberries rinsed and drained, 3/4 cup honey or maple syrup, 1 egg plus 3 egg whites, 1/4 cup of canola oil, 1/3 cup pureed pitted prunes, 3/4 cup buttermilk or soy milk, 1/2 cup mashed banana, 2 tablespoons chopped walnuts, 1/3 cup of brown sugar. Directions: preheat oven to 350 degrees Fahrenheit. Lightly oil a 13-by-9-inch baking dish or spray with nonstick cooking spray. In a large bowl, sift together the flours, baking powder, baking soda, and salt. Fold in the blueberries. In another bowl, whisk together the honey or maple syrup, egg and egg whites, oil, prunes, buttermilk or soy milk, and banana. Combine the contents of both bowls, mixing briefly, then pour the batter into the baking dish. Smooth the top of the batter with a spatula. Sprinkle with walnuts and brown sugar. Bake for 40 to 50 minutes or until a toothpick inserted into the center of the coffee cake comes out clean. Let cool and serve. Chapter 10, Coffee Games. Regardless of whether you buy your coffee from a local coffee business or coffee cart, or if you brew your own at home or the office, it's important to take a coffee break and give yourself a moment or two to savor the flavor of your favorite coffee or tea drink. With today's advanced technology, it's easy to find coffee games to play online. Some of the best coffee game websites include the following: Addicting Games at addictinggames.com, AOL Games, https://games.aol.com, Arcade Town, arcadetown.com, Candy Stand, candystand.com/index.do, Coffee Break Arcade, coffeebreakarcade.com, miniclip.com/games/en, MSN Games, http://zone.msn.com/en/root/default.htm, Pogo, pogo.com, PopCap, popcap.com, TerraGame, terragame.com, Yahoo Games, http://games.yahoo.com/games/front. You'll need to create an account at your game site of choice. Most are free to join, a few are subscription-based. Some allow you to upgrade and receive access to members-only games. Others let you win cash prizes. All offer fun, entertaining, and oftentimes addicting games. Just remember to keep your game playing to a minimum when you're at work. Otherwise, you could get yourself in hot water, and no one wants that. Have fun and enjoy your coffee break games. Then get back to work. Chapter 11, Coffee Lingo. If you've ever walked into a coffee shop, you know that they speak a completely different language. Here's a list of common coffee lingo used in coffee houses across America. Add shot, add an additional shot of espresso. Americano, also known as cafe americano or coffee slim, an espresso diluted with hot water. Americano Misto, same as before, only using steamed milk. This drink is similar to a latte, but without the foam. Barista, name for a coffee house bartender. Café au lait, drip coffee and steamed milk. Cappuccino, espresso with foamed milk on top. Crema, the tan-colored foam that forms on top of an espresso shot. Demitasse, small cup for serving espresso straight. It's similar to a shot glass or miniature teacup. Double shot, two single servings of espresso. Drip, a regular brewed coffee. Dry, foamed milk. Espresso refers to a brewing method, not a type of coffee. Espresso is made by pumping hot water through finely ground, firmly packed coffee. Espresso is made from 100% Arabica beans. Espresso con panna, espresso served in a demitasse cup and topped with whipped cream. Espresso cream, espresso with 1 ounce of heavy cream. Espresso freddo, espresso served over ice. Espresso macchiato, espresso with foam. Grande, a large cup, generally 16 ounces or more. Granita, latte blended with frozen milk. Half calf, coffee drinks made using half regular coffee and half decaffeinated coffee. Latte, espresso made with steamed milk. Latte pugne, a mini latte with a full shot of espresso. Mocha, a latte with chocolate. A mocha usually consists of espresso and chocolate-flavored syrup, topped with steamed milk and with or without whipped cream. Mochaccino, a cappuccino with chocolate. No foam, steamed milk without any foam. Quad, 4 shots of espresso. This is also known as a double-double. Rice latte, latte made with rice milk. Short, an 8-ounce cup. Short and dry, a latte or cappuccino served in an 8-ounce cup and a minimized amount of milk relative to coffee. Shot, a single 1-ounce serving of coffee. Shot in the dark, regular coffee with one shot of espresso. Single, espresso made from a single shot. This is equivalent to about 1 ounce of coffee. Soy latte, latte made with soy milk instead of cow's milk. Tall, a 12-ounce cup. Triple, 3 1-ounce shots of espresso. Unleaded, term for decaffeinated coffee. Venti, a 20 to 24-ounce cup. White mocha, a mocha coffee drink made with white chocolate. With room, means to leave room at the top of the cup. With wings, a cup with handle. Chapter 12, Coffee Trivia. Coffee has a rich and colorful history. Here's a collection of fun, interesting, and educational facts about coffee. Number 1. Milk was originally added to coffee in the 1680s, when a French physician recommended that coffee a lot be used for medicinal purposes. Number 2. In 1763, Venice was home to more than 200 coffee shops. Number 3. The first coffee mill was invented in 1665 by London locksmith. Number 4. During the Civil War, American soldiers were provided with 8 pounds of ground roasted coffee as a primary ration. They were also given up to 10 pounds of green coffee beans. Number 5. In 1900, coffee was often delivered door-to-door in the United States by horse-drawn buggies. Number 6. Flavored coffees are created by applying flavored oils specially created to use on coffee beans after the roasting process. Number 7. In many parts of Africa, raw coffee beans are soaked in water and spices and chewed like candy. Number 8. Amsterdam coffee houses are not coffee houses at all. They are places to go to legally smoke marijuana. The brew they serve comes in a bowl, bong, or joint. Amsterdam coffee house menus consist of a variety of weeds, not beans. Number 9. It takes a coffee tree 5 years to produce its first full crop. Thereafter, it produces consistently for 15 to 20 years. A mature coffee tree yields about 1 pound of coffee per growing season. Number 10. 1 pound of coffee beans makes about 50 cups of coffee. Number 11. All the coffee in the world is grown within 1,000 miles of the Earth's equator between the tropics of Cancer and Capricorn. Number 12. The United States is the world's largest consumer of coffee, consuming more than 450 million cups of coffee per day. 13. Japan is the third largest consumer of coffee. Number 14. Both the American Revolution and the French Revolution were planned in coffee houses. Number 15. Turkish bridegrooms were once required to take a vow during their wedding ceremonies to always provide their wives with coffee. If they failed to do so, it was grounds, no pun intended, for divorce. 16. Espresso has 1/3 the caffeine of regular coffee. 17. Darker roasted coffees contain less caffeine than light or medium roast because caffeine is lost during the longer roast period. Number 18. The first Paris coffee house was opened in 1689 by a lemonade vendor, Francois Procope. 19. Coffee beans are actually berries. Coffee berries start as green berries, then they turn yellow, then red, then dark crimson. Number 20. Dorothy Jones of Boston was the first American coffee trader. She was granted a license to sell coffee in 1670. Number 21. In Greece and Turkey, it is customary to serve coffee to the eldest first. Number 22. Coffee strength and body are not the same. The strength of coffee refers to how much coffee is in the brew. The body of coffee refers to the richness or heaviness of the coffee taste. Number 23. The original coffee houses of Constantinople were called Gava Khana, meaning schools of wisdom. They were frequently used as meeting places for men of arts and literature. Number 24. Beethoven was an obsessive coffee lover who was so particular that he always counted 60 beans per cup when he prepared his brew. Number 25. The word tip dates back to London coffee houses. Brass boxes etched with the inscription, "To ensure promptness," were placed throughout the coffee houses to encourage customers to pay for efficient service. Number 26. The Italians drink their espresso with sugar. Number 27. The Germans and Swiss drink their espresso with equal parts coffee and hot chocolate. Number 28. The Mexicans drink their espresso with cinnamon. Number 29. The Moroccans drink their coffee with peppercorns. Number 30, the Italians make the best espresso in the world.
PrivateRights.com. Disclaimer. PrivateRights.com developed these ebooks to provide access to valuable information. Although we make every effort to offer only accurate information, we cannot guarantee that the information we make available is always correct or current. PrivateRights.com does not warrant or make any representation as to the quality, content, accuracy, or completeness of the information, text, graphics, links, and other items contained in these ebooks. Consequently, no one should rely upon any information contained herein, nor make any decisions or take any action based on such information. PrivateRights.com or any subsidiaries are not responsible for any action taken in reliance on the information contained herein and for any damages incurred, whether directly or indirectly, as a result of errors, omissions, or discrepancies contained herein. Full terms and conditions can be found at http://www.privaterights.com/termsandconditions.html.